our communion, I'm sorry, our entrance antiphon. You have redeemed us, Lord, by your blood, from every tribe and tongue and people and nation, and have made us into a kingdom, priests for our God. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. The special intention for this Mass is for the repose of the soul of Brian Loker. And with that in mind, let's acknowledge our sin and so prepare ourselves for the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, author of our freedom and of our salvation, listen to the voice of our pleading and grant that those you have redeemed by the shedding of your Son's blood may have life through you, and under your protection, rejoice forever unharmed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Paul came into Antioch in Pisidia, he said to the synagogue, "My brothers, children of the family of Abraham, and those others among you who are God-fearing, to us this word of salvation has been sent. The inhabitants of Jerusalem and their leaders failed to recognize him, and by condemning him, they fulfilled the oracles of the prophets that are read Sabbath after Sabbath. For even though they found no grounds for a death sentence, they asked Pilate to have him put to death. And when they had accomplished all that was written about him, they took him down from the tree and placed him in a tomb. But God raised him from the dead. And for many days he appeared to those who had come up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem. These are now his witnesses before the people. We ourselves are proclaiming this good news to you, that what God promised our fathers, he has brought to fulfillment for us, their children, by raising up Jesus. As it is written in the second psalm, 'You are my son. This day I have begotten you.'" The word of the Lord. Responsorial psalm. "You are my son. This day I have begotten you. You are my son. This day I have begotten you. I myself have set up my king on Zion, my holy mountain. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. The Lord said to me, 'You are my son. This day I have begotten you.' You are my son. This day I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for an inheritance and the ends of the earth for your possession. You shall rule them with an iron rod. You shall shatter them like an earthen dish. You are my son. This day I have begotten you. And now, O kings, give heed. Take warning. You rulers of the earth, serve the Lord with fear and rejoice before him with trembling. Rejoice. Son, this day I have begotten. Alleluia. 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 I am the way and the truth and the light, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where we are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Raise your hand if you're still driving. And raise your hand if you're still driving and don't know GPS. Nowadays, people are already familiar with the GPS and they use it very often because it's so easy. And it's just helpers to go to any short way to go to the direct destination. But then for those people who go in the long way and go into the stranger way, doing in the, some bad circumstances, we know that sometimes we cannot count on the GPS. Because first, sometimes it's having the update well enough so it did not give us the right direction. It just turns us go around and around and around, and we don't know what's going on. Second, we have to charge it. If we use GPS from our phone, and if it's our battery, it's going to be a big trouble. And third one is need a signal. Because if we go up to the area that there is no signal, it runs us like crazy, right? But those people who just go in the short one don't even know that one. They're so familiar with GPS, and they think that with GPS they can do everything. So my friends, we live in this society. We think that when we have money, we have everything. We think that we have the technology, we have everything. But then when we go in the long journey, especially when we face with many barriers in life, do we still know that whatever belongs to human creations is going to be a mistake? There's just only one. I am the truth, the way, and the life. No one can come to my Father except through me. Do you get it? Please stand. With faithful and hopeful hearts, we lift up our knees to the Lord. For Pope Francis and our Bishop Kevin Van, Timothy and Titan, may the intercession of Pope St. Pius V help guide them in their pastoral decisions. Let us pray to the Lord. For our civic leaders, may God bless them in their service to their community. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who feel lost or abandoned, may they be comforted by the warmth of the Lord's shining presence. Let us pray to the Lord. For all in this faith community engaged in education, may the Lord bless their decision and service. Let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, especially Brian Loker, may they be brought swiftly to their eternal home by the risen Christ, let us pray to the Lord. And for our own special intention that we silently keep in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we strive to walk in the shadow of your beloved Son. Hear and answer the prayers we have placed before you according to your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, we become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care, they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Make thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover had been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast out and renewed, and in creative of life it restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy every land, every people, as those in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he has betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Calvin, Timothy, Titus, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostle, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be called as your eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Dear Jesus, come into my heart and be with me today.
Our communion antiphon. Christ, our Lord, was handed over for our transgressions and was raised again for our justification. Alleluia.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you.
Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits, prowls about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Prayer for priests and religions. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
While the storm clouds gather far across the sea, let us swear allegiance to the land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair as we raise our voices in a song. The storm clouds gather far across the sea, let us swear allegiance to the land that's free.